This morning I'm reading from Philippians chapter 2. Philippians 2, 1 to 11. If you have any encouragement from being united with Christ, if any comfort from His love, if any fellowship with the Spirit, if any tenderness and compassion, then make my joy complete by being like-minded, having the same love, being one in spirit and purpose. Do nothing out of selfish ambition or vain conceit, but in humility consider others better than yourselves. Each of you should look not only to your own interests, but also to the interests of others. Your attitude should be the same as that of Christ Jesus, who, being in the very nature God, did not consider equality with God something to be grasped, but made himself nothing, taking the very nature of a servant, being made in human likeness, and being found in appearance as a man, he humbled himself and became obedient to death, even death on the cross. Therefore, God exalted him to the highest place and gave him the name that is above every name, that at the name of Jesus every knee should bow, in heaven and on earth and under the earth, and every tongue confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father. May the Lord help us to understand His word this morning. Every day our lives get busier. But this morning I ask you, what is the worth of a life? There are many people coping with illnesses. Some are sick and don't even know it. So if you could add another year to your life, what would it be worth? Well, God thinks you and I are priceless. He has such a high value placed on our lives that He gave His own Son's life to save us. Our lives are precious to Him, but our souls are even more valuable. We all know that our bodies are temporary, and it's the soul that lives on for eternity. Well, if you lose your soul, you lose in the life to come. Mark 8, 36 and 37 says, what good is it for a man to gain the whole world, yet forfeit his soul? Or what can a man give in exchange for his soul? Choices. Life is all about choices. We make decisions every day. What will you wear today? What will you have for lunch? What are you going to do? What will you worship? What will you think? Every day we make countless decisions that brings us closer to God or not. Gloria Gaither says this about choices. Choices mend a broken relationship. To say yes to a difficult assignment. To lay down some important work. To play with a child. To visit someone who may be forgotten. These small choices may affect many lives eternally. William Booth, the founder of the Salvation Army, had a great vision. I would say, a disturbing vision by the look of that picture. And I already apologize that you couldn't see the animated version, which is, I'm quite impressed with. But I think it's very important that we see through the eyes of another person what the world looks like out there. And in that video, he showed people on their iPhones walking away, and there's people just right there behind them reaching out asking for help. And they turn because they're texting on their phone. It was a good depiction of how we are today. What is your vision? Have you ever felt like you have missed out on an opportunity to serve God? God needs you to reach the lost. Whether it's a family member, a friend, or someone who you've never met, a complete stranger, God needs you, and they need you. And the question this morning is, are you willing? William Booth said, while women weep as they do now, I'll fight. While children go hungry as they do now, I'll fight. While men go to prison in and out as they do now, I'll fight. While there is a drunkard left, while there is a poor lost girl on the streets, while there remains one dark soul without the light of God, I'll fight. I'll fight to the very end. Luke 9:10 says, for the Son of Man came to seek and save what was lost. As you look around your world today, do you see people on their cell phones? Of course you do. We even see them as they're driving on their cell phones, as dangerous as that is. People listening to their iPods, using their laptops, their tablets. People are busier than ever. Their time is taken up with material things. Perhaps we should call them idols. Jesus says, John 10:10, the thief comes to steal and kill and destroy. I have come that they may have life and have it to the full. Seriously though, people are dying. Do you care? Do you care? The name of the video is called Who Cares? Jesus always saw a person in need, and he had compassion. When he met the Samaritan woman at the well, he looked beyond her sin and saw her spiritual emptiness, and he appealed to her longing for God. When Jesus saw Zacchaeus, the tax collector, who had climbed up into a tree just to catch a glimpse of Jesus, he didn't rebuke him. He told him to come down. I'm going to go to your house. It was there that Zacchaeus came to salvation. Corinthians 1:3-4 says, praise be to God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of compassion and the God of all comfort, who comforts us in all our troubles so that we can comfort those in any trouble with the comfort we ourselves have received from God. This morning, are you so busy with life that you really don't notice the people drowning in sin? Or are you reaching to save those souls within the reach of your hand. You've been rescued from the waters and are now on the rock. 1 Corinthians 1:18 says, "For the message of the cross is foolishness to those who are perishing. But to those who are being saved, it is the power of God." We live beyond our means to gain the material things, hoping for happiness. But you and I know that happiness is not found in things. Things can't bring pure joy into your heart. Matthew 6, 19-21 says, "Do not store up for yourselves treasures on earth, where moth and rust destroy, and where thieves break in and steal. But store up for yourselves treasures in heaven, where moth and rust do not destroy, and where thieves do not break in and steal. For where your treasure is, there your heart will be also." We sometimes get entangled in our own lives, and we forget that God calls us to be active in this war against sin. And we often want Jesus to look after us, to provide for us, bless us, and be there for us all the time. Do we realize that his desire is to see that none is lost on his watch? Luke 5:31, Jesus tells us, "It is not the healthy who need a doctor, but the sick. I have not come to call the righteous, but sinners to repentance." This morning, this is not only a church. This morning you're in a hospital. Amen. Thank you, Lord. And this is where people come to be healed spiritually. He is right down in there in the water, struggling to save all he can. In the meanwhile, we go on with our busy lives. We don't always see the struggling. And we don't see the person missing out on the one thing that can make a difference in their life: salvation. Have you given all your all to him? Have you forgotten what you're living for or who you're living for? Time is ticking away. We certainly don't know the day or the hour that Jesus will return, so we must be ready. Hebrews 9:27 says, "Just as man is destined to die once, and after that, face judgment." Don't let another day pass without making sure that those you love, they know the Lord Jesus. You know very well John 3:16, "For God so loved the world that he gave his one and only Son, that whoever believes in him would not perish, but have eternal life." That's our responsibility, to share the light of Christ to this world. And I urge you this morning to be ready for Christ's return. Be ready to witness to others, and be sure that you are being watched and everything you do and say has an impact on those around you. Do you care? to. If you have not made a choice to follow Christ this morning, I invite you to ask him into your heart and to ask him to save you from the destruction of this world, to store up treasures in heaven, to save your soul. Romans 6:23 says, "For the wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life in Christ Jesus our Lord." This morning you can begin anew. If you have something in your heart that is hurting you, I invite you to come here to the mercy seat, here to the front, and pray about that. Perhaps you may be feeling weak or defeated in your Christian walk. Then I urge you to give your cares to God and allow him to carry those burdens for you. And if you feel it weighing down on you, and you can hardly keep your head above the water, then I pray that you'll bring those struggles to the Lord as well, and be renewed in him as we spend some time in prayer.